Hey guys, this is Matt Kaur from ctrl+paint.com, and today I'm going to talk about the difference between opacity and flow inside the brush tool. But as a quick reminder, if you look below the post, you'll find links for free brushes and worksheets, as well as in-depth premium series available in the Ctrl Paint store. So I've set up a little chart here, and we're going to look at how a single brush operates with different settings of opacity and flow. And you can do this with any brush you want, but I've actually attached the brush I'm using here as a download. So if you want to try and replicate the same exact results I'm using, go ahead and download the brush, give it a try for yourself. So first off, I have black as the color on my brush, and I have 100% flow and 100% opacity. So here you can see I can go from light to dark on a single stroke, and I can also do a bit of shading. And depending on the size of the brush, I can make pretty smooth blending if I want to. Now, if I were to just change the opacity of the brush, leaving the flow at 100%, I'm going to drop the opacity down to about 25. The results are going to be quite a bit different. I can still make a light mark, but it does not go all the way to black. And the reason for that is that it only goes to a maximum of 25% opacity. So if I were to draw a single mark and push as hard as I could, and layer over and over and over myself, it would still only be 25% opacity. Then if I lifted the pen and did that again, you can see it has a bit of a buildup. So where the two strokes overlap is 50%, and where they only have over the white of the paper is 25%. And then if I were to try and do some shading like I did with the previous example, it's not gonna have the same buildup effect. Only once I lift the pen and make a second mark is it going to do that. Now I'm going to reset the opacity back to 100%, and I'm going to set the flow down to 25%, kind of reverse those settings, and we'll see what that looks like. So a single mark can go all the way to dark. Even though the flow is at 25%, you can still make a mark at the full opacity. And then as I render with a single stroke, I can build it up. So this is a primary difference between using flow and opacity. And technically, I'm not exactly sure what the flow is doing under the hood. Every explanation I've heard is a little bit different, but it seems to be the rate at which the pigment is coming out of the pen. And this was initially designed around a setting that physical airbrushes had. It was sort of like a little valve that would determine how much pigment came out of the nozzle of the airbrush at any given time. But in real-world terms, I found that it allows you to have a bit of a softer touch. I find it's easier to do smooth rendering because you're letting out less and less of the pigment at a time, even though in a single stroke you can still go from light all the way to dark. Okay, so let's do a quick review here. If you're on 100% of both opacity and flow, you can go from light to dark in a single stroke. And within one stroke, you can begin to build up tone. If I were to turn down the opacity, a single stroke overlaid over itself is never going to build up tone. When I lift the stroke and make a second stroke, at that point it begins to build up. And finally, if I were to lower the flow, I can still make a mark that goes from light to dark, but less pigment is coming out of the brush at any one given moment. And I generally use lower flow when it comes to things like smooth blending. And I'd also like to mention that this is generally a sense of personal preference. I know artists that use primarily opacity, and they're always layering on glazes and painting in that way. And for them, that works great. Personally, I like to only use flow. So I almost always keep my opacity at 100%, and then I'll occasionally lower my flow when I want to do certain types of rendering. If I want to have lots of pigment, I'll have a high flow. If I want less pigment, doing more sensitive marks, well, then I'll have a lower flow. But I came to that personal decision based on experience. But what I'd encourage you to do is figure out what makes most sense for you. Don't just accept that I use low flow, so you should too. Maybe opacity is the way you want to go. So make a sheet like this and try some experiments. Keep everything constant and just change one variable at a time and see how it feels. Because when you're actually painting, there's a lot of other brush settings that are going to add additional variables. You're going to have color and texture, potentially blending modes, and all of these are going to change the feel of the brush. So if you can isolate the sense of flow and opacity before worrying about any of those other things, you're going to have a better ability to handle the brush tool. So give it a try and have fun. Thanks for coming to the site, guys.